And this morning we're talking about applying fake tan and getting a flawless finish, but also correcting any mistakes you might have made along the way when time is against you, and also maybe when you don't have the right products at home. And Karen Brown joins me this morning. Good morning to you.
Good morning.
And good morning, Laura. So first of all, Karen, can we talk about common mistakes?
Absolutely.
And Laura has made some of those.
She has,
by
indeed.
Accident and purpose.
Yeah. Laura is a typical fair Irish skin type, and I suppose despite the fact that we have the highest percentage of fake tan users per capita in the world,
we are
in Ireland,
huge users, aren't we?
Absolutely. We still see an awful lot of fake tan disasters on the streets of Ireland.
So we're not getting it right, despite
the plethora of products on the market as well. But as you can see here, Laura's kind of got two flips of the coin. She's got excessive tan on areas there, like her feet, her knees.
Okay.
Again, she's not got an even finish there on her shins. That's a common problem on the legs, is actually getting a streak.
That
finish.
Has happened to me plenty of times.
Absolutely, yeah. And what it is that a lot of people actually don't wax or shave or do their hair removal maybe 24 hours before they apply their fake tan.
Okay.
So they don't actually give their skin time to actually heal, so that the tan gives an even finish when you're actually applying it. Again, people don't tend to moisturise and exfoliate properly, so that's a huge barrier in terms of your perfect fake tan application.
Okay.
So that's one of the top tips, is to actually do your hair removal 24 hours before at least, and to also make sure that your skin is properly exfoliated.
Okay.
On the other side here, you can see that Laura...
Oh, your arms are even worse, Laura. Yeah. You're a disgrace.
She is struggling to remove fake tan remnants here. So you can see really clearly, again, very, very fair Irish skin type. She probably used a product that was a little bit too dark.
Too
for
dark.
Her skin,
I was just about to say that.
Is a common problem as well. So always make sure that you
but
get
it. But it does sit in the lines of our
it
wrists,
does.
Doesn't it?
And the drier areas. So like that, your elbows, your ankles, your knees, your knuckles, your wrists. So we've got some really kind of cheap homemade products that are really effective in terms of removing your fake tan. We've all gotten out the bottle of Domestos
use
the old pot scrubber to try and remove a fake tan disaster.
And it's always when you've no time on your hands.
That's
and
it.
You're running to
you're
a
under
wedding
pressure.
Or something.
Yeah, you've left a last minute. It's always the case. And we see it an awful lot in Ireland specifically. But the first product we actually have here is a combination of lemon juice, brown sugar, and just a little teaspoon of honey, just for consistency.
Okay.
Lemon is a natural astringent.
So that's this bowl here.
Exactly. Yeah. This is this one here. So we just pre-mixed it beforehand. So some lemon juice there to act as a natural bleaching property, so that actually helps to remove the, you know, the colour from the skin.
Colour of the pigment.
Then the sugar actually works as the exfoliating property, so again that helps to vigorously remove any fake tan from the skin when applied.
Okay.
And then the honey just acts as, you know, a combination to combine it. The second product we have here is the oil. So this is the natural virgin olive oil, known for its moisturising conditioning properties, and we've just mixed that with a little bit of sea salt. So what we actually are going to do here is apply it onto dry skin. Again, a common problem that people have is that they actually run the product over skin when they're in the shower. So the best thing to do is use it on dry skin.
Okay.
Before shower.
Outside the shower.
Absolutely.
Before your shower.
Yeah, definitely. So we're just working it into the skin here.
And Jerry Hall was only saying in the interview we showed yesterday that she uses olive oil in her hair.
That's it.
So
absolutely.
Plenty of uses for
olive
it.
Oil is fantastic, and everybody has a bottle of it in the house. So like that, rubbing it into the skin pre-shower, then jumping into your shower, doing your light exfoliation with a, you know, a mitt or a sponge.
Okay.
So just work that into drier areas like that. And what you can actually do then is you can damp cloth it off the skin.
Okay.
So you'll really see here when you're vigorously working it into the skin.
So it evens it out, but will it kind of take it away as well?
Absolutely. I mean, you can see there the remnants. I mean, this is a tan that's been on a couple of days now at this stage. You can see the patchy effects here.
Mm-hmm.
But when you vigorously work it into dry skin, you actually get really, really effective results.
Great.
So remember, pre-shower is the best thing for that one there.
Okay. What about the wrists and the arms,
The wrists,
Karen?
Again, this is a fantastic product. This is the Corora Micropeel. So this is an enzymatic and glycolic peel.
Okay.
You actually apply this.
So if you're organised enough to have this product at home, of course, you can use that.
Absolutely. And it's a brilliant product. It's $14.99. It's really good for sensitive skin because there's actually no grain in it, so it's a grain-free product.
Okay, because some of them can be quite harsh
on
your skin.
Absolutely. And especially on sensitive areas like the neck or the chest, or again, even some people like find that their hands are quite sensitive too, so they don't want to be, you know, overworking in a product that's quite kind of intense on their skin. So you can see here the enzyme actives actually actively remove
the dead skin
cells. They're
lifting it up. Yeah.
So you would again work this onto dry skin, pre-shower. It's really, really good for targeted areas. It's not the type of product you use all over your body. You would use it on your elbows, your ankles, your knees, your wrists again. So you can see quite clearly that this is actually working the product.
This is an effective solution.
So it's dissolving the fake tan, it's dissolving the dead skin cells. Mm-hmm. And it also really, really helps in terms of preparing the skin for a fake tan application. Okay. So it helps to actually remove the dead skin cells before you're doing the fake tan application to even out your skin, the drier patches.
Okay, so the most important thing is on dry skin before you get into the shower, you need to do this.
Yeah, and I mean, you can just see even the elements of transfer there just from the wrist onto the little wipe. So it's really, really an effective product. It's fantastic.
Okay. Let's talk about a few tips when you're doing your fake tan.
Absolutely.
Let's run through them briefly, Karen. Here we are.
Remove
all body lotions.
Absolutely.
So get rid of anything you might have on your skin.
Absolutely anything that's going to act as a barrier between your skin and the actual fake tan from activating.
Okay. Wax 48, or you mentioned that, or shave 24 hours before.
Yes,
of course.
Exactly.
So the hair removal needs to be done. Rub on an ice cube over the face.
It's brilliant, yeah, because what actually happens is a lot of people would put on their tan when they're out of the shower and their pores are open. And sometimes you'll actually see in the areas like across the bridge of the nose, the chest, maybe even the shins, you know, these little speckles or dots. So if you actually use an ice cube to run it over the likes of the nose or in a damp cloth, then you have a really, really good result in terms of
closes the pores.
Exactly,
brilliant.
Yeah.
Lots more tips and details on your website, of course, Karen.
Absolutely, yeah. And then finally, to finish in terms of perfecting the tan, we have the Karora Instant Tan. This is an Irish brand. It's one of the best fake tans on the market in terms of an instant wash-off product, and it's actually available between $9.99 and $14.99.
Okay, and that's in chemists around the country?
Chemists around the
salons.
Country. So this is actually your fake tan perfector. So if you've had that disaster, if you can't actually get your fake tan off, or if you haven't got time to properly perfect it before you've got an event or a quick fix or anything like that, you will just put this product onto the skin. And it actually suits every single skin type. I'm quite sallow, whereas Laura is the typical fair Irish
yes.
skin type. And you can see it actually adapts to the natural pigment in your skin
too. And it looks quite dark on Laura's skin, but I'd imagine once you kind
you have it blended out, exactly. And you can work it in with a moisturiser as well if you want a much softer finish. So
brilliant.
If Laura just turns over the back of her arm there, you can see how we can easily...
Circular motions.
Yes.
Karen, we're out of time,
motions.
Unfortunately. All the details on the website.
Brilliant.
And you're also doing a perfect pins competition, so check that out on the Karora Facebook page.
Thanks a million, Anna.
Thank you very
Great
much.
Stuff.
Thank you, Laura. Good sport. We'll go back into studio.